In this video, I will solve level 3.2 of Master the Mainframe 2020. Level 3.2 is Rex 1. Click on it. Go down. Click on here. This is the PDF we have to download. Download and open it. This PDF has 12 steps. In step 1, we have to open a terminal. So click on terminal. New terminal. Then copy the files from public source to your source dataset. So let's go to datasets. Here we have a source dataset. My source dataset is empty. I have to go to the mtm2020.source. Here is the dataset. I have to copy guess number and some rex. I have to copy both of these. Copy this into my source dataset. Give here paste. Give the same name guess num. Also copy some rex. This is some rex. Copy and paste. So now my source dataset has two members. This is guess num and this is some rex. Now in your terminal you have to give GOWE. This is my terminal. Give here GOWE. Then we have to give this command. Copy this, paste it here and enter. I have already created this, that's why it is showing me already exist. For you it will not show this. It will actually create this profile for you. It will say something like profile created successfully. Then what we have to do in step 3 is to run these two commands. Just run these two commands. Then we have to run this command. Give here your user ID. And you can see it was successfully executed. In step 5, start an address space. So copy this command, paste it here. Address space began successfully. Key is this one. Then run this command. So paste it here. Instead of as key, you have to give this key. So this is the key. Copy this and paste it here. So GOWETSO send as my key. Then I have to give data execute. So give double hyphen data. Then apostrophe execute single apostrophe. The dataset name 07252, my user ID dot source, then in the brackets SOMERE access, a single apostrophe, then double apostrophe. Press enter and you can see the code executed again. Exactly like before. Step 6 is now complete. Now in step 7 we have to run guess num code. So give the same command and instead of some rex give guess num. Press enter and you can see it executed this code. Now to guess the number I have to give the command like this, data. And then in the double apostrophe, I have to give the guess. The number should be between 1 and 10. So give here command like this, GOWETSO send as this key data is 1. Enter. That is not it. Try again. So let's give something else. Let's give 3. That's not it. Let's give 4. No. Let's give 9. It's not 9, let's give 10. 10 was the correct answer, and I tried 21 times to get this answer. Then it is asking us to look at the code, and here is the code. Only 16 lines are there. Do loop until the guess is not equal to secret. I am giving the guess. Then if guess is not equal to secret, then it is saying that's not a try again, and then it is counting how many tries are there. Secret is a random number from 1 to 10. At the starting of the program, tries are set to 1. So this was step 9. Now in step 10, what you have to do is we have to add some code to this program. This program should give feedback if I enter a number less than 0, if I enter a number greater than 10, and if I enter a number which is not numeric. So suppose I enter something like A or B or C, then it should tell me that you have to enter a number and not an alphabet. So this is what you have to do in step 10. And in step 11, it is telling us how to do this. There is a link given here. You can open this link. And it is telling me about Rex. In Rex, there is a function called data type. Data type can tell us whether the function is in lowercase, uppercase, it is a number, it is a symbol, or it is alphabet, or it is in hexadecimal. So this is the function of data type function. So we have to add data type in our program so that we can detect the user input. So these are step 10, 11 and 12. So let's add an if loop and a data type to our program. So this is the program. After pulling guess, what it is doing is it is asking us what is your guess, and then we will enter guess, and then it will check if it is equal to secret. If it is secret, then it will exit and say you have guessed it correct. Otherwise, it will be in the loop till the answer is correct. So give here if, and then we have to use the data type function, data type of the guess. So we are checking what is the data type of guess. So data type will just guess whether this number is a alphabet, number, or some other data type. So put this in a loop. If data type not equal to a number, then say please enter only numbers. And also we have to put a do here. So give here do. And here give end. So here it is showing us data type in the bracket. This is number, this is character. So this is how we will use data type function. Same way we have used here, if data type, the number is not equal to numeric. If our data type of guess is not numeric, then do this. And what we can do is, we can put this if else loop also inside this if else loop. Here give else and then give the whole loop. The else should be here. So pull the guess. This do is for this end. Pull the guess. If it is not number, then do. Not number, then end. Else. If it is not equal, then do. It is not equal, try again, then give if. Control S to save it. So we have completed the third requirement, that is enter a number that is not an integer. What about enter a number less than 0 or enter a number greater than 10? So let's add some more loops. So here let's add one more if, that is, let's add here if guess is greater than 10, then do say please enter between 1 to 10. number greater than 10 and then give end. If guess is less than 0, then do say number is less than 0, please enter between 1 to 10. So this is our final code. I have removed the do loops, we don't need them. Let's remove this one also, do and end. And this will be our final code. First, it is checking whether the guess is a number. If it is not a number, then it will just simply exit. Else, it will check whether the number is greater than 10 or it is less than 0. If it is not, then only it will execute this last loop. So let us execute this code now. I am thinking of a number between 1 and 10. Let's give the number as some alphabet like A. And it is telling us please enter only numbers. Let's give a number greater than 10. Let's give 11. And it is showing us that the number is greater than 10, enter between 1 to 10. So let's give less than 0, that is, let's give minus 1. And I will see number less than 0, enter between 1 to 10. So our code is successfully working. Now let's see what is the number. Let's try 0, let's try 1, let's try 2. So the correct answer was 9. And I got it in 14 tries. So our code is successful. Now to complete this challenge, we just have to submit CHK3. So let's go to public.jcl. Here is CHK3. Let's submit it. Job submitted 9050. Here go to system print. And here you can see Rex1. Which is correct. So our challenge Rex1 was successfully completed. Here also, if I go to completed tab, I will see that Rex1 challenge is showing here. Level 3.2 is successfully completed. Let's now complete level 3.3, that is Rex2. If you like my videos, then you can support me by buying my mainframe course. After buying this course, you will get 19 hours of mainframe training. This course will teach you COBOL, JCL, VSAM, TSO, ISPF, Unix System Services, and CICS. You can watch the free preview before buying my course. Make sure you buy the course using the referral link in the description.